Oh, you had to refresh? Let me, I'm just retweeting my own tweet. Alright. Okay, so I need some advice. Because I see there's 25 people in the chat, which is nice. And I need advice on what to do next in this game. Because, like, I wanna unlock stuff. And so I don't know what I should do. Should I do challenges? Should I do a run with a specific character? If anybody knows, because some of the people who watch these I know actually know a thing or two about Isaac. Go for Platinum God. I hear that is nay impossible. I think somebody I know said to me it took him hundreds of hours to do that. Do a challenge. Oh, everything on hard. You know what? This is a good idea. I'm going to try a run on hard instead of medium. And see if that does anything. And I'm just going to pick regular old Izzy, which is still my favorite character to play with. I do believe you can connect a controller, recent towels, but you're right. It's a twin stick shooter. Which is not... That doesn't lend itself to a keyboard. Okay. So. This is my first time playing this game on hard. I don't know what it means. Oh, you love my Romo tweets. Okay. I don't know what this is. I'm gonna have to open up my wiki again. I think it's called like platinumgod.co.uk. I did not Romo is a superstar. I'm just joking though. I'm not even like I don't really have a football team. Like I'm not really shit talking. Like, I just make jokes, you know? Let's see. Can be used to go in and out of a curse room without taking damage. Okay, cool. So I can actually go in here and it's no problem. How about that? That's a nice power-up. I'm liking this. And on top of that, it also doesn't... Oh, well, whatever. It also protects me from damage for the first hit I take in each room. Ooh. What's broken? I can't remember. I think this is one of the first power-ups I ever got in this game. Da 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 da. Okay. Oh, eh. Okay. So yeah, as I said on yesterday's stream, I'm going out of town for about a week. And so I'm not going to be streaming. And then I'm going to be back in town, but won't be able to stream for another about another week on top of that. So going to be a bit of a dry spell. It's a pleasure. Yeah, family stuff, whatever. I have not met anyone who has loved Ghost in the Shell. You know who's gonna love it? You know who's gonna go apeshit for that movie, I feel like? People in Japan. Oddly enough. Like, I do feel like the Japanese... I do think that there is a thing that they enjoy... They enjoy watching their... There's stuff that, like, Hollywood adaptations. Now, this isn't universally true, obviously. But, like, when people here were annoyed about who was cast and stuff, like, in Japan, people were, like, awesome. Like, people loved it. So, and also, like, they spoke to Oshii, Mamoru Oshii, the director of the original anime Ghost in the Shell. And he visited the set, and he gave his blessing. I'm sure there was a lot of PR push like that. Because it wasn't just him. It was, like, Kenji Kawai, who's the composer. And Kenji Kamiyama and Mamoru Oshii or something like that. They all visited the set and took pictures with everyone and gave their blessing. And I'm sure... But they were Japanese Americans, not Japanese actors. Like, are you talking about Japanese actors in Japan? Because Japanese American actors were angry. But as far as I know, the people actually in Japan did not mind. But you know what? That's not even the problem. It's like that movie Gods of Egypt. I was like, forget the whitewashing debate. That movie was just terrible. Like maybe let's have that debate about movies that don't suck. Like, believe me, nobody wants to be in Gods of Egypt. You want to be in a good movie that makes a lot of money. You don't want to be in a movie that's a joke. Like, Chadwick Boseman, he's in that movie. Nobody will ever remember him for that movie. People will remember him for playing Black Panther or playing James Brown he played some other big role, now that I can't remember. But, like, nobody will remember the whatever god that he played in Gods of Egypt who could multiply himself and was the guardian of knowledge or whatever and was also kind of a pervert. Like, who cares? That movie was terrible. And the guy who made it also, like, went on the internet and was like, fuck all of you, my movie was amazing and you don't know what you're talking about. Gerard Butler just plays King Leonidas in that movie. There's a scene where he's like, sons of Egypt, go out into the desert. And it's exactly 300. I don't know what item I got right now. That was not good. I need to pay attention while picking up items. Hold on. Oh, here it is. Oh, okay. The CGI was bad. There was some horrendous green screening. It was clearly shot. There's one scene that they clearly shot outside in the desert. And it's the scene right before they're attacked. Jamie Lannister and the guy from Pirates of the Caribbean or whatever. They're sitting out like in this like temple outside, and then they're attacked by the two serpent ladies. That's the one scene that's clearly outside. You can tell the lighting, it's daytime. But then there's other scenes where they're like in the desert at night, at like a sunset. And it is absurdly clear that it's fucking green screen. Like I said, to an embarrassing degree. And they all have like long sort of wavy hair, so it's already hard to green screen against that. Interestingly, there's a way around that. There's this movie. I don't know if you watched it. Hold on. Yes, Alex Proyas, the director of The Crow and Dark City. He's actually good. There's this movie called Oblivion. It's with Tom Cruise. It's a really underrated movie because it has a couple of big problems, I think, that hold it back from being a really great movie. Especially the casting. Like, I really think it shouldn't have been Tom Cruise, and it also shouldn't have been Olga Kurylenko. Not good. Anyway, in that movie, he lives in a glass house that's up in the sky. And there's many scenes where, like, it's at sunset, and there's a pool, and they're walking through these glass walls, and everything is this crazy sunset. Yeah, Ioba, you're right. And it has a really amazing ending, and it actually also has some really good, like, set design, sound design. So all of the stuff in the house, where you see them at night and daytime, and there's clouds and stuff, they said, look, we could have green screened that, but it would have been really hard because you need to light the set appropriately, and then you also need to erase all of the reflections from the windows. And so what they did was they went to Hawaii, and they shot some like HD footage on top of a mountain in 360 degrees. And they just built a giant projection screen around their set and just played that footage on it. So you have 360 degree footage of real sky. And then it also lights your set appropriately. So if it's the sunset, they look orange and stuff. And then you compare that to something as fucking fake amateur, somebody made it in his garage, green screen, in Gods of Egypt. And that movie's expensive. It's not like an indie flick. You know, Jeffrey Rush, who's an Oscar winner, is in that movie. So yeah, Gods of Egypt looks bad. It's really bad. The script is really pathetic, and also nobody knows anything about Egyptian mythology. You know a little about Greek mythology. All of us know a little bit about Greek mythology. You know Zeus, you know Mount Olympus, you know Apollo, you know stuff like that. Nobody knows Osiris or Set and what their thing is. Yes, from the guy who made the Tron reboot. Yes, yes. So yeah, nobody knows Egyptian mythology, and it's really weird, and they didn't explain it really well. Everything was really literal. I didn't like that. Like, I think that, take Lord of the Rings, okay? You know how in the beginning of Fellowship of the Ring, they tell you the history of the ring, right? And so they say Sauron, he had this one ring, and then the humans and the elves, they marched on Mount Doom to fight him. And now you see Elrond in his youth, like commanding an army, and he's marching with Isildur, the king of the humans. And here comes Sauron, and they say, but the power of the ring could not be undone. And here comes Sauron, and he's a giant knight, and he's throwing people left and right because he's huge. That's a metaphor. They didn't mean that he actually became a big monster. The point is that he was so powerful that they couldn't defeat him. And the way they visualized that was they showed you him as a giant monster, okay? And I think Lord of the Rings did that well in a few places, a few key places, where all of these things of myth, if you read the Silmarillion, it's all very mythical. It's like, oh, this hero, he fought the giant beast, and that's it. Like, they don't explain to you the mechanics of how somebody fights a giant beast. Like, so here's another good example in Two Towers, when they show you what happened after Gandalf fell down the bridge of Khazad-dûm. And they show you how he fought the Balrog. That was really cool, because how does a wizard fight a monster like that? You don't know. So they figured it out. They did a really cool way where they were kind of battling as they were falling. Gods of Egypt tried to do stuff like that, but it ended up being way too on the nose literal. Like, I guess Ra in Egyptian mythology, every night he has to battle this kind of abstract evil that wants to destroy the universe. And so they just did that. He's just on like a big floating spaceship. And this thing comes, this big monster comes, he has to shoot fireballs at it and runs away. So like, it was unimaginative. Also, I got so annoyed at it that I actually wrote a story treatment that I think was way better than the actual concept of the story. Because it made no sense. I can't remember the particulars now because it's been a while since I've seen it. No, Joel Edgerton is in... he's not in Gods of Egypt. He's in Exodus Gods and Monsters. That's what Edgerton is in. And oh boy, don't get me started on that piece of shit. I can't believe Ridley Scott made that movie. It's fucking terrible. Okay, left or right? Left or right? What do you say? I got two bombs. Oh, you know what? Okay, hold on. Is there a blue-tinted rock here? No. I mean, this might be. Oh. Oh, of course you forgot about Exodus Gods and Monsters. It is a criminally forgettable movie that has... I mean... Oh. It has so many problems. Like, it... First of all, it kind of misses the whole point of the Bible. Which you'd think... You'd think a movie about a biblical story would actually, you know, get the story right. The problem with that story, though, is that it's already been told in the perfect way. The movie Prince of Egypt is an absolutely perfect movie about Exodus. You can't do a better one. So it doesn't matter. Like, why even try? You know, I haven't seen... It's weird. I was just thinking about Darren Aronofsky's Noah. I have not seen it. I want to see it. Because I heard that it has some interesting things in it. And I like Darren Aronofsky. Just came out today or yesterday that his new movie is going to be a horror movie with Jennifer Lawrence. I wonder what Satoshi Kon project he's going to rip off this time. No, I'm kidding. He is heavily influenced by him, though. Like, between the scenes that he lifted for Requiem for a Dream from Perfect Blue, and the fact that Black Swan is basically Perfect Blue with ballerinas, sort of. Oh, is Joel Edgerton in... Is Joel Edgerton in Noah? Ah, Devil Room and Jesus Juice. Okay, awesome. Okay. Oh, I think this is Flight. I do believe this is Flight. Oh, this is perfect. And look at me. I'm all godly, and I got a halo, and now I'm going to go demon, devil, demon. Awesome sauce. Wait, now I can do a whole mess of things. Oh, wait, I don't have key. There, where can I get a key? Is there anything I can do? I guess not. And I don't have... I'm very fast now, and I'm also flying. So, I have the power of flight now. Which is a nearly incomparably good power to have in this game. There are very, very few things that are as good as flight. Okay. Look, here's the thing. If you're going to do a biblical story... You have to balance, you know, wanting to do something artistic and maybe different with I want to say honoring the source material, but I don't mean like in a religious way. I mean in the same way that you would honor any source material. If you're adapting a book, I expect you to treat your source material with a certain level of respect because you're adapting it for a reason. If there wasn't something about it, you wouldn't be making a movie out of it. And I feel like a lot of these, like, more modern takes, they don't do that. They're like, let's do a thing. Let's turn this into some kind of message that echoes what's going on now. Like, that's Gods and Kings has some of that. And it feels really weird. Do I think it will be shit? Here's the problem with it. It has to live up to two things, not just one thing. Because there's a lot of fans of the book. And so you have to... Meeting their expectations is going to be virtually impossible. Because we're talking about a book that has a scene where 12-year-olds have an orgy. So you're not gonna faithfully adapt it. But, you know, I think it's still possible to please fans of the book with a well-made movie. It's actually two movies, because the story of it is a story in two parts, where the one where they're children, and then the second part is when they're adults. And so it was a team. It was like two TV movies that they did. And that's the thing. So you have to live up to the expectations of the people who like the book. You also have to live up to the expectations of people who like the TV movie, and specifically Tim Curry and his Pennywise version of Pennywise. Because the movie itself is not amazing. It's kind of dated, and it's all right. It's not bad. But Tim Curry is just great and so memorable. One of the most memorable things to ever come out of a TV miniseries. You know, like, he's a villain, but from like a weird low level, like 1990 says Ioba. I think I saw it in 1992, maybe. I remember the first time, because I was living in Israel, and I remember the first time it came on TV, and they promoted it, they were gonna air it, and I sat down, I watched it, and it scared the crap out of me, because I was maybe 9 or 10 at the time. They were terrible, and yet Tim Curry sort of transcends the fact that he's in a bad TV movie and does something really memorable and really scary. There's some really scary visuals in that movie. Like the part where they where they're looking at the book of the 19th century, and it starts moving, and he sort of climbs up to the camera, and then he pulls his shoves his hand out of the book. That's such a great, scary moment that's not violent, it's not gory, right? And then he's just speaking at the camera, and he goes like, I'm gonna kill you. I'm gonna kill all your family. You're gonna wish you never met me, or whatever. It's really... just really simple and super, super effective. Whoops. No, I didn't want to get teleported. Damn it. Oh, no. This is really bad. Ah, crap. Now I don't know where the secret rooms are, whereas before I did know. This is bullshit. Anyway, do I think it'll be bad? I think that the fact that it's R-rated is already a pretty good sign. It also looks kind of nice. Like, the stuff that we've seen looks kind of nice. It has that Stranger Things 80s feel. Weirdly enough, because in the original, they were children in the 50s. And so the adult phase of the movie's in the 80s. In this one, the child phase is in the 80s. And so then presumably the adult phase is going to be in the sort of nows. So if their kid's in 1987, so then 30 years after that, that's 2017. So that's neat. I kind of like that. I like that they chose a different kind of clown. It also makes more sense because he's been alive for so long. And presumably, he's had that clown persona for that entire time, or most of it, anyway. Oh my god! My weapon is really not powerful enough. I think the stand is way cheesier. But it also has some not bad performances by Jamie Sheridan as Randall Flagg, and fucking Rob Lowe's in it, and Corin Nemec, who is Parker Lewis. There you go. I can name... Oh, Gary Sinise is in it, too. And Laura San Giacomo. I can name the entire fucking cast of The Stand by, just from memory. How random is that? I don't remember what Judgment is. I just fucking named the entire cast of The Stand. Nerd. Okay, see, because I had... Oh, this is gonna be a good idea. So look what I'm gonna do. Okay. Alright. That didn't help, I guess. Yes, the hot evil chick is Laura San Giacomo. She was on a... She had her own show. I don't remember what it's called now, but, but she was actually on a show that she was the star of back then. Well, her and Corin Nemec, they were the traitors, right? No, Just Shoot Me... Wait, she was in Just Shoot Me? Wasn't that... Oh no, Tia Leone was in the Naked Truth or something like that. Wow, Just Shoot Me. I haven't thought of that show in a bazillion years. It's weird how things that you, like, literally thought about all the time at one point in your life. I mean, I didn't think about it all the time, but it was, you know, it was a big part of, like, pop culture, and it just disappears completely. Like how now, you know, they're remaking Legends of the Hidden Temple. Oops. They're remaking Legends of the Hidden Temple. Until I heard that they were remaking him, I totally forgot that it even existed. And I used to watch that all the time when I was a kid. When I used to come to the States, because I used to come here in the summers to visit my family. And of course, like a good kid in the 80s and 90s, all I did when I was here was watch TV. Because I didn't have all the good shit over there when I was a kid. So all the good cartoons and that kind of stuff, I would just plop myself in front of the TV for fucking 5 weeks. Now, I mean, you know, like, I went to the movies too. Like, back then, like, if you went to the movie theater here, you would see movies that wouldn't open back home for another, sometimes like 6 months even. Now, everything opens on the same day. Now, like, movies will open in Europe before they open in the U.S., like the weekend before or something like that. But yeah, back then it was like I would see, like, a movie would come to Israel in March and I had seen it like the previous August. Yeah, I was the spoiler master. That is correct. I introduced everybody I knew to Ninja Turtles. I was the first person ever in like my expanded circle of like school and friends who had heard about Ninja Turtles. And I remember when it finally came, I was like, "See, I told you." Because I had, you know, I was a young kid, and you know, like, you visit, right? You see this thing on TV, you see maybe two episodes of it, and it's amazing and whatever. And then you gotta tell your friends about it a couple of months later when you're like back home and then school starts and whatever. And so you don't remember all the details exactly, and because you're also a kid. So, you know, it's funny. I remember like struggling to like remember all of their names, and of course not getting it right. You see, I'm gonna have to come here later when I have some more bombs, because I don't remember. I do remember that my grandmother was like, "Come watch this, because this is a cartoon, but it's not." But it's not for kids. And that must have been... I'm trying to think. You see, the problem with me trying to place memories is that my grandparents have lived in the same apartment my entire life. So I can't go like, "Oh, they were living at this house at the time." It's always been the same house. And it stayed remarkably the same. Kind of looks the same. Most of the same furniture. They changed the color of the rugs or whatever. That's about it. So, when was this? This had to have been in the very early era. So, maybe the first two... Within the first two seasons, I think. I had heard about it for the first time. I don't know when it came. But yeah, I was exposed to different things there in Israel. Like we got some of the Peanuts specials, but not all of them. Obviously, like, not the Christmas one or the Halloween one. But all the other ones, all the non-holiday ones we had, like Snoopy Come Home and a couple others. Oh, it's called Divine Shield or something like that. It's just not visible now because I got something else and it's masking it. And I also watched some stuff that's from Europe. That you that Americans don't know about. No, it's not Holy Mantle. It's called... Hold on a second. Isn't it called Divine Shield? I thought it was called Divine Shield. It's like a cross... Hold on, I'll tell you the name of it, because I remember what it looked like. Here it is. It's called... Oh, yeah, Holy Mantle. You're right. Correct. Good call. So yeah, like if somebody here is from England or from France, like I know some stuff that they know that Americans don't know about. Or maybe I know it in a slightly different way. I was not into Tintin. I had a friend who was French when I was growing up, and he was into Tintin and he had a lot of Tintin comics, but they were all in French. He had a lot of really interesting French comics that I now know were part of, like, there's a whole crazy French graphic novel sort of, you know, community or whatever. And he had these crazy comics. And a few years ago, I got on this kick of, like, trying to find lots of stuff like that from my childhood, like think about cartoons that I watched and stuff and find them like on YouTube. And so one of the things was I got on that comic and I was like, I remember this and I don't know what it is. And I looked and I looked and I did lots of Google searches. I couldn't figure it out. So I sent him a message on Facebook. And I said, hey, do you remember this thing? And he was like, oh, sure, I still have it. And he scanned the cover of it and sent it to me. And then from that, I found it. And that was so cool. By the way, this thing is called Harlequin Baby. Do you know what that means? There's something called Harlequin Syndrome that you must never, ever Google. It's a disease. It's a disease that sort of puts your organs on the... You're kind of like inside out. You kind of look like you're inside out. Which is kind of like what this thing looks like. Imagine that, but like real and horrifying. Spirit of the Night. Yes, I did get Spirit of the Night. I got it in a devil deal room. Yoshilus. Ichthyosis. I don't know what that is. Wait, I went into the secret room already. Yeah, and I had like 6 hearts at that point, so it was very easy to. It was an easy deal. What does it say? Harlequin is a syndrome condition characterized by asymmetric sweating and flushing on the upper thoracic region of the chest. No, that's not it. That's not what I'm thinking of. Maybe it's called Harlequinism or something like that. Yes, I do know that, Eoshalus. I will go in there eventually. Oh, you know what? There's a heart here, so I can actually easily do this. Ah, save me a bam! Oh, look, I didn't even get take the... Ichthyosis. Oh god, I hate that these guys never... Okay, good. So far... The fact that I'm playing on hard has not been a substantial impediment. It actually hasn't been an impediment at all. I mean, I don't know if I could have told that this was hard in like a double blind test. Maybe I'll feel it more later, or maybe I just got a bunch of good power-ups early, so. Which Castlevania? There's like a million of them. I think I very soon am going to be playing some Horizon Zero Dawn or maybe Nier Automata, one of them. Thank you for that. I kind of want a, come on. Oh, for Christ's sake. Did it just say it's dangerous to go alone? You fucking Zelda quoting motherfucker. Okay. Is Horizon Zero Dawn gonna drop in price soon? How does this work? I don't know how this works. I am not of this world. 2D Castlevania, best Castlevania. But which one? Isn't like 3 or 4 the one that people say is the best one? Because it's not Simon's Quest, certainly. If there's anything the AVGN has taught us, it's that Simon's Quest is not a good game. Or at least, it's not the best Castlevania game. Yeah, Symphony of the Night, sure. Can I get Symphony of the Night on this? Like, can I just download it? How much does it cost? Because I would totally get Castlevania. Yeah, for like $10. Okay, cool. I think I said this on one of my previous streams where, like, at first I was like, oh, really? I bought a PlayStation 4 to play, you know, a 16-bit roguelike. But then I was like, wait, that's a bullshit way of thinking. It's the way the man wants you to think, man. Because, like, I like indie movies. A lot of the movies I watch, I love a good, low budget, does a lot with a little movie. I know Ioba likes those too. But like what, with gaming I can't play anything that's not AAA? That's ridiculous. So it's true that it doesn't utilize all the capabilities of the system, but who gives a shit? I mean, you could argue that one of the capabilities of this system is to connect to a network and download games of all eras, you know? No, it's not backwards compatible. I think the Xbox is... So initially I considered getting an Xbox One because I have a 360. But it's clearly not the one to get, per my understanding. Also, like, none of the... What's Justice? Oh, I want this. Okay, good. Yeah, but like, I got my 360. It's here. I can use it if I want to. Oh, wait. Calloused feet. Oh, no, but I don't need calloused feet because I'm flying. The one time. Because I fucking love this power-up. This, for people who don't know, is calloused feet. Which is, means you can, like, walk over spikes and walk over, all the acid and the blood and the stuff that it gets spilled on the floor by certain enemies and then hurts you. All right, now this room is hard. Whoop. Damn, that room was challenging. Yes, I don't need that if I can fly, exactly. So I'm saying, like, I'm constantly searching for that, and so the one time I get it, I don't even need it. Which is fine. I'd rather be able to fly and not need it. Alright. Let's see. So Symphony of the Night is not available for... So what were you playing it on? Steam? Seems like this is the trick, is to get them one by one. Well, oh, PS3. Can I get it on 360? I mean, the problem is I won't be able to stream if I play it on 360. But I don't have a capture card. Oh yeah, Shadow of the Colossus. I've heard of that one. Okay, so that's the boss room, and it's one of those double wide rooms. Oh, there's a whole other section of the map I haven't visited yet, because that's where the secret rooms are. Alright, let's see. What? Where did these go? Oh, I forgot that they jump up and then land randomly. Fuck. Oh, I forgot that. I thought that was explosive. God hand? Wow. $10 on 360. Like I said, the only problem is I won't be able to stream it. I'll be able to play it. But all I can do is play it, then tell you about it later. Speaking of telling you about it later. A reminder to listen to the latest episode of the Neon Cast. It's on YouTube, and I talk about Ghost in the Shell and also Legion. And there's also old episodes about other things. And, ooh, what's a pickaxe? Does that turn my tears into pickaxes? Is there no pickaxe? I can't... Hold on. I can't find it. Let me see. Uno momento, por favor. Oh, here it is. Oh, notched axe. Yeah. Each charge of this item allows either to break all rocks, pots, and secret doors in the current room. That is damaged. Oh, I see. Ooh, this is nice. Okay. Okay.
Anyway, what the hell were we talking about before I got that? Oh, I was talking about the Neon Cast, I think. And about how I didn't like, Yes, I was. And, yeah, I was happy with it. I also put in some theme music that I threw together, quickly. Because I have a lot of, loops that I made lying around. I did a thing so that there would be a thing. I think I'm gonna augment it with some other stuff. I have some sound drops and shit. What is that? Is that like a nun's hat? Is that a burqa? Oh, it's a habit. Oh. I don't know if I need that. Yeah. I don't, my charge item isn't an active, it's not a killer item. It's a block breaker. So what show am I thinking about watching now that Legion is done? That's a good question. Well, first of all, there's anime. Because the anime season started now. There's Attack on Titan season 2, My Hero Academia season 2. Eccentric Family Season 2. Grand Blue Fantasy Season 1. And many other things. Oh, what is that now? Crystal Ball. Upon use, reveals the entire map and gives player a random tarot card, mystic rune, or soul heart. Huh. So, I'm going to come back for this later, because I want to break a bunch of blocks on this floor. I want to find a room that has blocks in it, and then break them. Oh, you know what? I haven't been in the challenge room yet. And my hearts are full, so that's where I'm gonna go. The best girl is about to show up in My Hero Academia. That's impossible because the best girl is already there. What's her name? The main girl. One who can make you float without gravity. Uru. I can't remember her name. Urara, is that it? Oh, it's Guppy, Guppy. Ooh. So here's a question for y'all Isaac people. Are the spawns just better when you play on hard? Because I feel like I've been getting some really good items. Okay. And I forget what this exact thing is. Oh, here it is. So see, Tsuyu-chan was not bad. Tsuyu-chan was not bad. But I still like, whatever her name is. Yeah, see, I don't know if I want this and not the other one. Oh, what, you know what? I actually don't need the crystal ball because... Okay. Here's what I'm gonna do. Because the crystal ball gives you a tarot card, I'm gonna go there, I'm gonna activate it, I'm gonna get my tarot card, And then I'm going to change it back to this. I think that's good. Okay. Let's see. Okay. So. Awesome. Now I can take this. There we go. The hermit. I don't know what that does. Does that warp me like to a secret room? Oh, to the shop. And then after that, it's a random teleport. I've already been to the shop on this level, I think. Yep. I did not pick up any coins. But, yeah, I'll take a soul heart for sure. Do I have lots of bombs? Oh! I wanted to go to the secret room to bomb some mushrooms. That's what I was going to do. Oh, no, that was in the previous level. I forgot. Crap. Okay. Mushrooms. You should pick it up even if you get rid of it. It counts towards the guppy transformation. Oh, really? I thought you had to have all three guppy items at once in order to become guppy. That's what happened to me when I became guppy. I had all three at once. And that run was pretty easy, I gotta say. Once you turn guppy... Oh no! I hate when it does this! Okay. Come on, you bastard! Come on, you fat bastards! Whoa! Whoa! I hate the little short hops they do. Large hops are easy to deal with. But I have a hard time getting the timing right on the short hops. Oh. He's gonna do a short hop. Okay. Alright. Excellent. Shot speeds up. Okay. I have literally nothing left to do on this floor, right? There was nothing that I was gonna do. I would rather have this than the pickaxe, I think. Okay. Okay, okay, okay. I can go. I can go. Alright. We got ourselves a run going. Oh wait, am I in Necropolis? I do believe so because of the music. Necropolis is hard as shit. Ever since I unlocked this, my runs have gotten way more difficult. Whoa. Okay. Okay. Oh, I see. The secret rooms are up there. You should use Guppy's head whenever you have a chance. Oh, really? I thought it erased the flies when I got into a new room. That's why I wasn't using it. Ah, my bad. Okay, that's good. That's a good tip. Okay, good. That's a very good tip. I'll just keep doing that. Oh no, laser! God, I fucking hate these. Okay. Okay. Oh, that was useless. Okay. Uh-huh. Oh, bad gas. Pheromones. I don't even remember what this one does now. Oh, the shop. Oh, should I go? Is there a shop here? I don't even remember now. Whatever. Okay, that's good for later. I hate these ghosts. They're such bastards. Oh yeah. Let's get some pills. None here. Okay. Okay. Oh no. Are you a wizard? Oh my god, I'm only getting bad pills. I swear to god. Alright. God damn this thing that makes me shoot in weird directions. One of the best power-ups I got last night was a thing that made all my pills good. It wasn't PhD, it was something else. Because PhD, I think, makes all your pills good. But this was something else that also did that. As like a secondary effect. Oh, what's this? Oh, Ouija board. Oh, okay, but I already had spectral tears. Look how scary I am. If I see an item that looks like a dunce cap, don't pick it up. Also not, tick is another thing I never pick up now. A permanent wizard shot. The magician. What's the magician? I do not know. Oh, okay. Oh, it gives you purple tears for one room. Okay. Oh, what's the little satchel? It's like a fanny pack. I bet that's what it is. I bet it's actually a fanny pack. Let me see what it's called. If it's called fanny pack, I'm taking a shot. How about that? Where is it? Let's see. If I search fanny pack, am I going to find it? Oh. It's fucking fanny pack. Hold on. I got to take a shot now. I said I would, right? Okay. Here, I wonder if you can hear the sound of me taking the stopper off this whiskey. Did you hear that? Like, here, hold on. Glug, glug, glug. Oh my god, I have so little. Okay. Screw it. Alright. This is not a shot. This is like, this is a glass of bourbon, not a shot of bourbon. A promise is a promise, though. Use your right, my active, correct. I keep using it, but okay. But what does fanny pack do now? I don't even know. When Isaac is hit, there's a chance he will drop a pickup. Oh. Thank you.
I think I'd rather have a soul heart. I'd rather have a soul heart right now. Okay. Oh, now I can... Oops, that was a waste of a key. The flies were in my way. I don't remember what the magician does now. Forget. Okay. Oh, yes. Okay. I'll do that on the boss room. Yeah, it's homing tears for him. Okay, good. See, now I hit it immediately so that Yoshilus wouldn't yell at me. And I immediately hit it immediately when I'm done clearing the room. Man, when your spiders are powerful, it's a crazy effective weapon. Alright. Let's see. I gotta say, Spectral Tears, another invaluable power-up. Can you buy a waifu avatar for your PSN account? I thought there were only a very limited number of ones you could just choose from. Okay. All of these pills are going to be bad, right? Let's see. Okay, these are telepills, which are bad. This I don't know. Okay, this one's bad. So there's two here unknowns. Bombs the key? What does that mean? Switches number of bombs and keys. Okay, I had a lot of both, so it didn't matter. Pretty fly. Wow, these are pills I've never heard of. Gives Isaac +1 fly orbital, which blocks enemy projectiles and damages fly type enemies and such. Okay, that's just one more fly. Okay, I don't need the rest of this crap. Is there anything else that I should go to? No. I should bomb. You know what I should do? I want to go bomb in this room. I want to bomb some skulls. Because I know skulls sometimes drop good shit. And I have a bunch of bombs. See? I know if they occasionally they'll spawn one of these guys. Oh, and 16 keys. How about that? So yeah, occasionally they'll spawn an enemy. Like that. But they also have a chance of giving you some good stuff. I'll try one more. Ah, look at that. It would be nice if I actually remembered what any of the things in this game do. It's actually not true. I actually remember... It's just the cards that I don't remember. The cards No, I actually even remember the pills. It's just the cards now. Here it is. This goes to the secret room. Boo. The hermit. The magician. So, the shop... this is still by far my best one. Okay, is there another interesting room for me to mine for stuff? I don't think so. Okay,
So let's go fight the boss. Is this Mom? Am I at Mom? No, wait. Oh. Because I haven't opened all the openings yet. I gotta go all the way around here. It is Mom. Okay, cool. Let's do it. Okay, good, excellent. Right before I go into this. Ah, now what's this? It's some kind of baby. Some kind of baby. Let's see. I don't think I've ever seen this baby. It's blue and it has X's for eyes. Let's see. It's not a baby. Oh, here it is. Oh, Brother Bobby. Oh, he also shoots, which do 3.5 times damage. Wow. No, this is Brother Bobby. This is not Dead Baby. This is actually a really powerful. Your dog just farted on you. Okay. I am obscenely powerful right now, which is quite good. Okay, another shot of scotch or bourbon or whatever. Okay. Oh, laser! I'll keep saying this. Laser spiders, my least favorite enemy in this game. Oh, those, and the other one that I hate is the eyeballs that shoot electricity at you. I seriously can't even. Oh, I shouldn't have done that. Never mind. I should have bombed it from the other side. Okay. Okay. Bourbon Taster should be my name. Okay, why is there a thing like this in the corner? That's just weird. Oh, see that eye? That's the thing I hate. But there's mom hands in this room. Any more? Come on. Come on, mom hands. Alright. Okay. Keys. I'm gonna break my key record. Oh, I see, Oshalus. That's pretty clever. That's interesting. Okay.
It's so unfair. This game rewards you for having flight. There should be power-ups that you just can't take if you have flight, just to even out the score. Because, like, it's like that joke how when you go to the bank, to get a loan from the bank, you need to prove that you don't need a loan. Like, you need to prove that you're financially stable enough to repay the loan. But if you were, you wouldn't need a loan. That's my block of jokes about the banking world, ladies and gentlemen. Yuck it up here with the comic taster. Yeah, but yes, this game rewards you for having flight. It's like, oh, you have flight? Here are all these great items that you can only get if you already have this one other great item. Should it be the other way around? Should it be like, oh, you don't have flight, so here's this awesome thing that only you can get because you don't have flight. It's like socialism. It's like redistribution of power-ups. I don't know what's up with all the bombs. Maybe did I take something that increases my chance of getting bombs as room drops? I think that could be it. I'll be here all week, exactly. Don't forget to tip your servers, ladies and germs. Sorry, you guys excited about Game of the Thrones? The Game of the Thrones? I was born wrong. Ah, thanks for the soul heart. See, it was worth all those coins. Okay. Yoba says meh. Yeah, I mean, it's fun, I guess. Like, it's, you know, I'm entertained by watching it, but it stopped. There was that thrill in the beginning because I was a huge fan of the books. Like, I read the books way before it was the global phenomenon that is, not to sound too hipstery, but so yeah, I would say, up until certain critical events in, like, A Storm of Swords, I was like, I just want to see what this looks like, because these scenes are so crazy, and I can't believe they're going to put them on a show, because it was this, you know, these crazy things that you would never saw coming, and you had never seen anything like it. So yes, there was this, like, excitement of having the people you know who don't know it watch it. You know what? I'll tell you what I don't like about the show. The big thing that they changed that I don't like, I guess, is that they decided to sexify it up. The books don't have a lot of sex in them at all. The books spend more time describing, like, the food that they're eating than, like, sex stuff. Well, so they chose to make that a more of a central aspect of the story. Which, is kind of a clever creative choice, because you're HBO and you're trying to get people to watch and stuff. But it felt a little weird because the books were way more chaste. if you will. HBO will often put stuff like nudity just because it's HBO. I will say that Westworld, which was great, Ioba, Westworld, actually used a lot of that nudity and stuff in a really interesting way that actually kind of made sense, I felt. Even though I initially thought it was going to be really cheesy and dumb, this is a cool boss. I've never seen this guy. So yeah, I thought Westworld, like, was way more smart in how it dealt with that kind of stuff. Alright. Oh, boy. Okay, hold on a second. I gotta examine. Because one of these things is like a zombie. It looks like a zombie baby or something like that. Is it a zombie baby? Zombaby? Hold on. Because what's this? Oh, rotten baby. Follows accidental spills of blue flies. One fly at a time. Okay. Blue flies, the hive mind item. Okay. And what is the pentagram? Hold on. Oh, here it is. It's this thing. Yeah, damage up. Should I take that one? Oh, and here's there's a heart. There's a half heart here. That's great. So it erased the devil deal. Because I got a heart piece now. Awesome. Now that's some luck. Oh, Curse of the Blind. What is Curse of the Blind? Wait, what's Curse of the Blind? Oh, okay, all items are replaced with question marks. That's bad. That's really bad at this stage of the game. I'm gonna be really afraid to take any items. Drunken Peasants? No, I have not ever seen the Drunken Peasants. I don't know what that is. So many keys that I don't need. Oh, what a weird variant on that enemy. It's one of those gophers, but he also has gravity. He has an attractor field. That's pretty interesting. Oh, unless something spawned, unless an enemy spawned an item. Or I went into like a spike room or something like that. Like those have items sometimes. Or like like if I got a black market. That's always possible. So yeah, I was trying to see if I could find something. Oh god. Come on, mom hen. Alright. Does it say, can enemies spawn items when they die? Some? Some rooms do. It depends. There's also like sins Like, you know, like if you fight a sin, if you fight like greed or something like that. Also in secret rooms. Oh, this is on Switch too? On one of those horrible tasting game cards? Really? Did the sins always drop the exact same item? I didn't know that. That's true. See, this room's gonna be easy because I don't have to avoid the spikes. Suck it, Mom. Wait, how do I get... Oh, am I gonna have to go all the way around? Is there more map here? Ooh, skeleton key. Oh my god, all these items that I don't need at all. Oh, I keep forgetting to use the guppy head. You gotta remind me to use the guppy head. Here, now I used it. That. Nice. Alright. Wow, this floor is big. Oh, this just reveals all the map, I think. What did I say? I don't even remember what it is that I said. Did I say something embarrassing? Oh, is this pink eye? Oh, yeah. Way better. Oh, suck it, Mom. I guess you're right. I don't know what bucket of lard is. Oh, health up but speed down. Oh, right, it makes you fat. I've gotten that. I've gotten that once. Okay. I have a bazillion keys. Are you kidding me? Yes. Oh no, wait. Oh, are you shitting me? Are you shitting me? There was a level skip there. And then oh, fuck me. What a fucking boo. I cannot believe that. You know what though? I'm gonna go bomb every fucking rock in this level to see if there's a fucking crawl space.
That was so mega, mega effing lame. Oh, see, umbilical cord. That's an item. Shouldn't it be? This game is all about heartache. It's like sports. It's like being a sports fan. It's like long stretches of disappointment, followed by small moments of joy. Yes, you're right. At least it was a successful run. That's true. And I did it on hard, which I had never done before. I wish I could get in here. Oh, you know what? Maybe if I hurt myself intentionally a bunch of times, I could do that. This is just a fool's hope. I mean, there's no chance that I'm gonna find one. What a bummer. What a bummer. Well, I was gonna have to go to bed soon anyway. Yeah, it's gonna be the end of the stream, I think. I need to, Oh. So wait, is something gonna happen now? Did I finish the game on hard? Interesting. See, it's it keeps giving me different endings. Hold on. What's challenges? Can somebody explain to me what is this? I just want to see what this is for a second. So, what's the challenge here? Is the challenge to finish the entire game like this? Is that it? Is there just one floor that's like this? Because this is neat. I kind of like playing like this. Huh. I kind of like this idea. Oh, no health. That's weird. Why don't I have a health bar? Can I only get hit once? Or does it just not tell me what my health is? Oh, wow. Hiding your health is really sadistic. So I had three. I had full health, I think. And then I had, so now I have three red and one blue now, and half blue. Yeah, that would be too cruel. Okay, remember I have three red and one half blue. Wow, look at all of this. This is crazy. No, 3 red, 1 half blue, I think. Because I think I had full health when I got the soul heart. Oh, whoops. No, wait. Ooh, shears. I don't remember what this does. What do pinking shears do? Oh, God. I don't know if I'm going to keep playing. Hold on. Oh, interesting. Well, this room is a waste. Wait, where am I going? Oh, okay. It's not just flight. It's flight and your body attacks. Oh, God damn it. I need a key. Can I get a key somewhere? Hold on a second. I know that feel when you don't have a key. Is nobody gonna give me a key? Yeah, for sure, Yoshilis. I think the next time I do one of these streams, it's gonna specifically be like a challenge run. Da 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 da. I mean, I'm mega weak right now, so like... Oh man, that's it. That's powerful as hell. Did you see my body? Did you see how powerful it was? Here, you see I can't take this. I have full health. Okay, so now I have 4 red. Okay. Nah, don't worry about it. We're just having fun. We're just having fun in here. Yeah, 4 red, 1 half soul. I think you're right. I do believe that's correct. This pinking shears thing is a perfect boss room power up. Because it's really strong. And it has a high recharge time. And I actually like a boss room power-up. Uratoni. I do like how nice all the lighting effects are because it's dark. Whoa. All right, so now I have 5 red, 1 half blue. So now I assume I have 5 red, and okay, 5 red, 1 blue, I think. Mm. Okay. God, now I've completely lost track of my hits. Isaac. Well. Oh, great. It's dark. I can't see the map. I can't see my power. Just how would you just reverse my controller so that I can die humiliated? Okay, that's the boss. Oh, wait. Yeah. Excellent. But I gotta go get some keys. I don't have a key. No, you know what? And I don't have any bombs left, so I might as well just go to the boss. Alright, Monstro. Your ass is mine, Monstro. Wow. What's that? Anybody know what this is? It looks like a hairball or something like that. Is this like Guppy's hairball or something? Oh, here it is. It is Guppy's hairball. I actually just guessed what this is just by looking at it. And can be swung back and forth dealing 3 contact damage. Yeah, I think this looks pretty good. Every time a hairball kills an enemy, it grows. Unlock this item by collecting 3 guppy items, I guess. Okay, so. Oh, like this? Okay. Alright. How many amnesias can I have? I mean, not that it matters, because I don't feel like I'm gonna... Oh, this is a short... I see this is a short run that I gotta do. I don't have to do, like, a full... I just gotta get to Mom and beat her, I guess. Oops. That's not what I meant to do. I don't have a key. I do have a key. I don't have a bomb. I whip my hair back and forth. I don't get what I'm doing here with this. Ugh! Christ. Daram tam tagadagadam. Sorry, I'm just trying to get this thing to kill them. It's just not working. I don't think... Oh, yeah, I guess it did kill one of them. Hold on. Good. Gives me an excuse to try and kill enemies specifically using this thing. Oh my god, I'm so gonna die. Oh god. Come on! These things always kill me. Christ. And I have exactly zero idea how much life I have. Mom's bottle of pills. Well, that didn't help. Whatever. Wow, look at all this shit down here. This thing can't collect hearts, can it? Spiders in the dark are the worst. Yeah, they're hard to see. So tired, guys. I'm falling asleep. Hold on. I gotta wake up tomorrow, but not super early. I gotta catch a train out of town in the morning. Isaac. I don't know. Let's see if I can do this quickly. Oh, the size of this thing resets at the end of the level? That's balls. Should stay big. Come on. Oh God, die already. Christ. Yeah, don't whip the hairball into explosive. Yeah, I guess you're right. I'm probably super close to death right now. Oh, crap. You like how I'm still alive? Somehow. Inexplicably, I'm still alive. But I'm being very cavalier in my play style. Oh God. Oh God. Oh God. Ah. Okay. Alright guys, thanks for tuning in. I gotta sign off and go to sleep. That was still fun. As I said, I'll do this again as soon as I can, which will probably be in a couple of weeks. Anyway, good night y'all.